Hi everyone, this is Glenda Ganzon and welcome to my Human Anatomy and Physiology class. And for today's video, I'm going to discuss the integumentary system, particularly with the layers of the skin. So stay tuned. Although you may not typically think of the skin as an organ, it is in fact made of tissues that work together as a single structure to perform unique and critical functions. The skin and its accessory structures makes up the integumentary system, which provides the body with overall protection. The skin is made of multiple layers of cells and tissues, which are held to underlying structures by connective tissues. So the deeper layer of the skin is well vascularized, and it also has numerous sensory and autonomic and sympathetic nerve fibers, ensuring communication to and from the brain. So this is a picture of layers of the skin. The skin is composed of two main layers, the epidermis, which is made of closely packed epithelial cells, and the dermis, which is made of dense, irregular connective tissue that houses the blood vessels, hair follicles, sweat glands, and other structures. And beneath the dermis lies the hypodermis, which is composed mainly of loose connective and fat tissues. Let me introduce to you the first layer of the skin, which is the epidermis. The epidermis is composed of keratinized, stratified squamous epithelium. It is also made of 4 or 5 layers of epithelial cells, depending on its location in the body. It does not have any blood vessel within it. Skin that has 4 layers of cells is referred to as thin skin. From deep to superficial, these layers are the stratum basale, stratum spinosum, stratum granulosum, and stratum corneum. Most of the skin can be classified as thin skin. Thick skin is found only on palms of the hands and the soles of the feet. It has a 5th layer called the stratum lucidum, which is located between the stratum corneum and the stratum granulosum. In this picture are slides that show the cross sections of the epidermis and dermis of. In the figure A is the thin and in the figure B is the thick skin. Take note that the significant difference in the thickness of the epithelial layer of the thick skin. The cells in all of the layers except the stratum basale are called keratinocytes. So what is a keratinocyte? A keratinocyte is a cell that manufactures and stores protein keratin. And again, what is a keratin? A keratin is an intracellular fibrous protein that gives hair, nails, and skin their hardness and water-resistant properties. The keratinocyte and the stratum corneum are dead and regularly slough away, being replaced by cells from the deeper layers. This is the picture of the epidermis. The epidermis is epithelium composed of multiple layers of cells. The basal layer consists of cuboidal cells, whereas the outer layers are squamous. Keratinized cells, so the whole epithelium is often described as being keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. This time, I would like to introduce to you the deepest layer of the epidermis, which is the stratum basale. So the stratum basale is also called the stratum germinativum. It is the deepest layer or the deepest epidermal layer and attaches the epidermis to the basal lamina and below which lie the layers of the dermis. The cells in the stratum basale bond the dermis via intertwining collagen fibers referred to as the basement membrane. So it's a finger-like projection or fold known as the dermal papilla. So the plural of dermal papilla is dermal papillae. It is found in the superficial portion of the dermis, and dermal papillae increase the strength of the connection between the epidermis and dermis, and the greater the folding, the stronger the connections made. In this picture are the layers of the epidermis. The epidermis of a snake has 5 layers. The first one is the stratum basale. Number 2 is the stratum spinosum. Number 3 is the stratum granulosum. Number 4 is the stratum lucidum. And the last one, number 5, is the stratum corneum. The stratum basale is a single layer of cells primarily made of basal cells. So what is a basal cell? A basal cell is a cuboidal shaped stem cell that is precursor of the keratinocyte of the epidermis. So all of the keratinocytes are produced from this single layer of cells, which are constantly going through mitosis to produce new cells. And as new cells are formed, the existing cells are pushed superficially away from the stratum basale. Two other cell types are found dispersed among the basal cells in the stratum basale. The first is a Merkel cell, which functions as the receptor and is responsible for stimulating sensory nerves that the brain perceives as touch. So these cells are especially abundant in the surfaces of the hands and feet. The second one is the melanocyte. So what is a melanocyte? Melanocyte is a cell that produces the pigment melanin. And this melanin gives hair and skin its color and also helps protecting the living cells of the epidermis from ultraviolet radiation damage. In a growing fetus, fingerprints form where the cells of the stratum basale meet the papillae of the underlying dermal layer, which is the papillary layer, resulting in the formation of the ridges on your fingers that you recognize as fingerprints. So fingerprints are unique to each individual and are used for forensic analysis because the patterns do not change with the growth of aging processes. The next one is the stratum spinosum. As the name suggests, the stratum spinosum is spiny in appearance due to the protruding cell processes that join the cells via a structure called desmosome. So the desmosome interlock with each other and strengthen the bond between the cells. It is also interesting to note that the spiny nature of this layer is an artifact of the staining process. So unstained epidermis samples do not exhibit this characteristic appearance. And the stratum spinosum is composed of 8 to 10 layers of keratinocytes formed as a result of cell division in the stratum basale. Interspersed among the keratinocytes of this layer is a type of dendritic cell called the Langerhans cell, which functions as the macrophage by engulfing bacteria, foreign particles, and damaged cells that occur in this layer. The keratinocytes in the stratum spinosum begin the synthesis of keratin and release a water-repelling glycolipid that helps prevent water loss from the body, making a skin relatively waterproof. And as a new keratinocyte are produced atop the stratum basale, the keratinocyte of the stratum spinosum are pushed into the stratum granulosum. So the stratum granulosum has a grainy appearance due to the further changes in the keratinocytes as they are pushed from the stratum spinosum. And the cells, 3 to 5 layers deep, become flatter and their cell membranes thicken and they generate large amounts of the protein keratin, which is fibrous, and the keratohyaline, which accumulates as lamellar granules within the cells. So these two proteins make up a bulk of the keratinocyte mass in the stratum granulosum and give the layer its grainy appearance. So the nuclei and the other cell organelles disintegrate as the cells die, leaving behind the keratin, keratohyaline, and the cell membranes that will form the stratum lucidum, the stratum corneum, and accessory structures of the hairs or hair and nails. On the other hand, the stratum lucidum is a smooth, seemingly translucent layer of the epidermis located just above the stratum granulosum and below the stratum corneum. So this thin layer of cells is found only in the thick skin of the palms, soles, and digits. The keratinocytes that compose the stratum lucidum are dead and flattened. So these cells are densely packed with elidin, a clear protein rich in lipids derived from keratohyaline, which gives these cells their transparent or lucid appearance and provide a barrier to water. The stratum corneum is the most superficial layer of the epidermis and is the layer exposed to the outside environment. So the increased keratinization, which is also called cornification of the layer, gives it its name. There are usually 15 to 30 layers of cells in the stratum corneum. This dry, dead layer helps prevent the penetration of the microbes and the dehydration of the underlying tissues and provides a mechanical protection against abrasion for the more delicate underlying layers. Cells in this layer are also shed periodically and are replaced by cells pushed up from the stratum granulosum or stratum lucidum in the case of the palms and soles of feet. So then the entire layer is replaced during the period of about 4 weeks. Cosmetic procedures such as microdermabrasion help remove the dry upper layer of the skin and aim to keep the skin looking fresh and healthy. So this ends my discussion about the integumentary system, particularly the layers of the skin. The first one, which is the epidermis. I'll be discussing the second layer of the skin, which is the dermis, in my next video. So once again, I would like to thank you all for watching this video and for listening to my discussion. And if you have any question, please write it in the comment section down below and I'll be glad to answer them all. Until my next video, bye everyone!